Okay, so this is the Thomas Bridge. You can see the sign up there. One of the four covered bridges here in this county. And these date back to the 1800s. This one is 1879. And you can see the wooden construction here. And looking up at the overhead. These are really old. And then a wooden highway. So here's a side shot of the Thomas Bridge, and it goes over Crooked Creek, which is right down here, and it bends off there to the left. They call that Crooked Creek. And again, here's a shot side of the bridge. It's in pretty good repair. And up there you can see the vents. It's not solid all the way up there, probably for circulation. And there's the entrance to the bridge, the covered bridge. And again, here's the other side of the bridge crossing Crooked Creek, and you can see the creek flowing there from right to left. And yeah, that's it. Pretty green here. So here's the underside of the bridge. You can see they put some square set timbering over there like we see in abandoned mines for support. They don't use this bridge anymore, obviously. They've had to bypass the road. But yeah, they put some supports in there. But over there behind those, the square set cribbing, you can see the original foundation. Just like right here next to me on this side. That's all original. From, I think it said 1877. And that's looking up at the how it was built underneath. So let's go take a walk through the bridge and check it out. Okay, so this is Plum Creek, and this is the Trusal Bridge. It's one of the shortest ones here in the county. It's only 41 feet in length, and that's the covered bridge there. And you can see right here the original footer. This dates back to the late 1800s, and that's when this was built, and that's the original footer. And then when they refurbished this bridge in 1990, they added the concrete foundations down there to give it some support. See over there to the concrete foundation and then the original footer underneath. Let's go check out the bridge. So you can't drive on these anymore because they're not strong enough to hold up the weight of a modern automobile. So they put another bridge in right over there and had to reroute the road. But again, a similar construction with the criss-crossed beams, and here's looking down. You can see the gaps in between the boards. There's the creek down there, Plum Creek. And looking up at the overhead, you can see where they put a metal roof on back in 1990.